Dear students, we are moving on to the fourth module of the subject Material Handling and Facilities Planning. As discussed earlier, the first three modules of the subject mainly concentrated on different aspects of facility planning regarding its layout design, computer algorithms to automate the facility layout, design procedures, considerations to be provided for factory layouts, benefits of a good facility layout and other related things. Now the remaining three modules mainly focus on the material handling aspects. In this module, we'll be dealing with material handling systems, material handling principles, classification of material handling equipment, relationship of material handling to planned layout. So, before we move on to the topic, let's first understand what is material handling. Only if we appreciate the need and benefits of a good material handling system, we could understand the relevance of each component used in the system. So, if one has to define a material handling system, it would be as simple as this. A material handling system is to provide right amount of right material at the right time, in the right condition, at the right place, in the right position, with the right sequence, at the right cost, using the right methods. Now, the essential requirements of a good material handling system may be summarized as: it should have an efficient and safe movement of materials to the desired place, timely movement of the materials when needed, supply of materials at the desired rate, storing of materials utilizing minimum space, and the lowest cost solutions to the material handling activities. Now we'll discuss about the importance of material handling system. A good material handling system may have the following benefits. Reduce the cost. Reduce the cost by utilizing space to better advantage, increasing productivity, making a few number of effective movements. Now next would be the reduce the waste. Reduce the waste by eliminating damage to materials during the handling process, maintaining proper control over the in and out of stock handling process. Third one would be improving the work conditions. Now you can improve the work conditions by providing safer working conditions, reducing the worker fatigue. Similarly, the last benefit of a good material handling system would be to improve the efficiency of the plant. Now you can improve the efficiency of the plant by providing a better organization of storage facilities. Next, we'll have a discussion on the different principles of material handling. We have almost 20 basic principles guiding the material handling system. First one would be the planning principle, then system principle, material flow principle, simplification principle, gravity principle, space utilization principle, unit size principle, safety principle, mechanization principle, equipment selection principle, standardization principle, flexibility principle, dead weight principle, motion, idle time principle, maintenance principle, obsolescence principle, control principle, capacity principle, and performance principle. We'll just have a look into what these principles mean. Now, planning principle, it simply means all the handling activities should be well planned prior to any event. Similarly, the system principles would be to plan a system integrating as many handling activities as possible and coordinating the full scope of operations. Operations which include receiving, storage, production, inspection, packaging, warehousing, supply and transportation. Space utilization principles would mean that to make an optimum use of the cubic space available. Similarly, the unit load principle would say increase the quantity, size, weight of the load that is being handled. Gravity principle states utilize gravity to move a material wherever possible and wherever it can be practiced. Material flow principle says plan an operation sequence and equipment arrangement to optimize material flow. Simplification principle, it simply means reduce, combine or eliminate unnecessary movement or equipment. Safety principle, as we all know, it should provide a safe handling methods and equipments. Mechanization principle, it states we have to use mechanical or automated material handling equipments. Standardization principle, it gives thrust on standardized methods, types, size of material handling equipment. Now, the flexibility principle states it should use methods and equipment that can perform a variety of tasks and applications. Similarly, equipment selection principle, it says consider all the aspects of material, movement and method to be utilized. Dead weight principle states reduce the ratio of dead weight to the payload in mobile equipment. And regarding the motion principle, equipment designed to transport material should be kept in motion. Idle time principle says reduce the idle time or the unproductive time of both material handling equipment and the manpower. Maintenance principle states we have to plan for preventive maintenance or scheduled repair of all handling equipments. The obsolescence principle says replace obsolete handling methods or equipments when more efficient method or equipment will improve the operations. Wherever possible, we have to employ this. Capacity principle, it says use handling equipment to help achieve its full capacity. We have to run an equipment to its full capacity. That is what it means. Similarly, control principle, use the material handling equipment to improve production control, inventory control and other handling. Now, the last, the performance principle, it says determining the efficiency of handling performance in terms of cost per unit handled, which is the primary criterion. Now, we shall discuss the factors that influences the selection of material handling equipments. So, we basically have few factors which greatly influences the material handling equipments or the selection of the material handling equipments, like the properties of material, layout and characteristics of the building, production flow, cost consideration, nature of operations, engineering factors, and then the last factor which influences is the equipment reliability. Now, the property of the material is very important. We have to see whether it is a liquid, solid or gas, and then what size, shape and weight is it to be moved, or important consideration can already lead to a preliminary elimination from the range of available equipment under review. Similarly, if a material is fragile, corrosive or toxic, this will imply that certain handling methods and containers will be preferred over the others. Now, layout and characteristic of the building, that is also very important. Another restricting factor is the availability of space for handling. Low level ceiling may preclude the use of hoist or cranes, and the presence of supporting columns in awkward places can limit the size of material handling equipment. If the building is multi-storied, chutes or ramps for industrial trucks may be used. Layout itself will indicate the type of production operation and can indicate some items of equipment that will be more suitable than the others. Floor capacity also helps in selecting the best material handling equipment. Now, the third one, if the flow is fairly constant between two fixed positions that are not likely to change, fixed equipment such as conveyors or chutes can be successfully used. If on the other hand, the flow is not constant and the direction changes occasionally from one point to another because several products are being produced simultaneously, movement equipment such as trucks would be preferred over the other available methods. Now, cost is a very important thing. The above factors can help to narrow the range of suitable equipment, while costing can help in taking a final decision. Several cost elements need to be taken into consideration when comparisons are made between various items of equipment that are all capable of handling the same load. Initial investment, operating and maintenance costs are the major costs to be considered. By calculating and comparing the total cost for each of the items of the equipment under consideration, a more rational decision can be reached on the appropriate choice. Now, the nature of the operation is also very important. Selection of equipment also depends on the nature of operations, like whether handling is temporary or permanent, whether the flow is continuous or intermittent, and the material flow pattern is vertical or horizontal. Now, there are certain engineering factors which also influence the selection of equipment, material handling equipments. It depends on engineering factors like door and ceiling dimensions, flow space, flow conditions, and structural strength. Now, reliability of an equipment is very important. Reliability of the equipment and supplier reputation and after-sales service also play an important role in selecting material handling equipments. Moving on, we'll just see how material handling equipments can be classified. Broadly, material handling can be classified into two categories: fixed path and variable path equipments. Fixed path equipments is one which moves in a fixed path. Conveyors, monorail devices, chutes, pulley drive equipments belong to this category. A slight variation in this category is provided by the overhead crane, which though restricted can move materials in any manner within a restricted area by virtue of its design. Overhead cranes have a very good range in terms of hauling tonnage and are used for handling bulky raw materials, stacking and at times palletizing. Now regarding the variable path equipments, we have no restriction in the direction of movement, although their size is a factor to be given due consideration. Trucks, forklifts, mobile cranes, industrial tractors belong to this category. Forklifts are available in many ranges. They are maneuverable and various attachments are provided to increase their versatility. Now, if we take a detailed classification of the material handling machines or equipments, we can say it is broadly classified into conveyors, cranes, industrial trucks and other equipments. Other equipments, it includes the hoist and the elevators. Now, when we consider the conveyors, we can see there are different types of conveyors available. We have chute conveyor, wheel conveyor, roller conveyor, chain conveyor, sled conveyor, flat belt conveyor, magnetic belt conveyor, trough belt conveyor, bucket elevators, vibrating conveyors, screw conveyor, pneumatic conveyor, vertical conveyor, cart on track conveyor, tow conveyor, trolley conveyor, power and free conveyor, monorail, sortation conveyor. Now regarding the cranes, we have different types of cranes available, commercially available, which are jib crane, bridge crane, gantry crane, stacker crane, tower crane and mobile crane. And a wide variety of industrial trucks are also available for material handling in an industry, which includes hand truck, pallet jack, walkie stacker, counterbalance lift truck, reach stacker, turret truck, order pickers, side loader, tractor trailer. And the very most important thing which is available in almost all advanced industry is the AGVs or automatic guided vehicles. Now conveyors are very useful for moving materials from between two fixed workstations, either continuously or intermittently. They are mainly used for continuous or mass production operations. Indeed, they are suitable for most operations where the flow is more or less steady. Conveyors may be of various types with rollers, wheels or belts to help move the material along. They may be power driven or may roll freely. The decision to provide conveyors must be taken with care, since they are usually costly to install. Moreover, they are less flexible where two or more converge. It is necessary to coordinate the speeds at which the two conveyors move. So that is one of the disadvantages associated with the selection of the conveyors. Now regarding the cranes and the hoist, the major advantage of cranes and hoist is that they can move heavy materials through overhead space. However, they can usually serve only on a limited area. Here again, there are several types of crane and hoist, and within each type there are various loading capacities. Cranes and hoist may be used both for intermittent and for continuous production. Now the wide variety of industrial trucks available in the market, they are more flexible than conveyors, since they can move between various points and are not permanently fixed in any one place. They are therefore most suitable for intermittent production and for handling various sizes and shapes of the material. There are many types of trucks, petrol driven, electric, hand powered and so on. The greatest advantage lies in the wide range of attachments available. These increase the truck's ability to handle various types and shapes of the material. Then we have other material handling equipments like containers, robots, things like that. Now the containers, they are either dead containers, like you have cartons, barrels, kits and pallets, which hold the material to the transported but do not move themselves. Or we have one another category which is called as a live containers, which includes wagon, wheelbarrows or computer self-driven containers. Handling equipment of this kind can contain both the material and it can also be operated manually. Now robot is one of the advanced method of handling the materials. Many types of robot exist. They vary in sizes and in function and maneuverability. While many robots are used for handling and transporting material, others are used to perform operations such as welding or spray painting. An advantage of robot is that they can perform in a hostile environment such as unhealthy conditions or carry very tedious tasks such as repetitive movement of heavy materials. The choice of material handling equipment among the various possibilities that exist is not easy. In several cases, the same material may be handled by various types of equipments, and the great diversity of the equipments and attachments available does not make the problem any easier. In several cases, however, the nature of the material to be handled narrows the choice. Now, we do have another set of category of material handling equipments which can be classified as something as elevators. Elevators are machines for lifting and lowering loads vertically with intermittent recuperating operation or recuperating motion. We have common types of elevators such as hydraulic elevators, monorails, cage elevators, hydraulic lift, bucket elevators. Now, very important thing that we have to discuss in this module is what is the relationship between the plan layout and material handling. Now, for your information, there's a very close relationship between plan layout and material handling. A good layout ensures minimum material handling and eliminates rehandling in the following ways. It is quite essential to have a very good layout so that you can reduce the cost incurred for material handling process. Material movement does not add any value to the product, so the material handling should be kept at minimum, though you cannot avoid it. This is possible only through the systematic plan layout. Thus, a layout minimizes handling. Now, next, the productive time of the workers will go without production if they are required to travel long distance to get the materials or tools, etc. Thus, a good layout ensures minimal travel for the workmen, thus enhancing the production time and eliminating the hunting time and traveling time. Space is an important criteria. Plan layout integrates all the movements of men, material through a well-designed layout with material handling system. Good plan layout helps in building efficient material handling system. It helps to keep material handling shorter, faster, and economical. A good layout reduces the material backtracking, unnecessary workmen movement, ensuring effectiveness in manufacturing. Thus, a good layout also ensures minimum material handling. I hope you all have got a basic understanding of material handling concepts. Thank you for your patience. Have a good day.